Okay, so we're going to be replacing this defective three-way switch. So first we'll put our ground wire around the green screw here. The red and the black travelers. Now the two travelers don't make a difference which screws you put them on. Okay, now we can put our red wire on the other baffling screw here. Some tape a little bit on the glue on the copper, so I'm going to scrape that off. Back to make sure that the wire is hugging the inside of the screw. Looks like I got the insulation under the screw, so I'm going to loosen this back up. It's a little harder working when you're looking into the light. But you just gotta deal with it. You can't always get everything you want. You might want the light behind you, but the light might be in front of you and you might not be able to get the light behind you. So I'm gonna open the screw up a little bit bigger. There it is, now it looks up. direction that the screw turns. Okay, so now we can just push our wires back into the box. Making sure that they don't hit anything. And keep our ground wire down. No wires are pushing against anything that we don't want them to push against, like sharp edges and be poked open. And we are all done. And this is a single pole residential grade switch. And you can see that it's not made with the same kind of quality. Just see the two little rivets here? That's all that's holding the housing together. And on the commercial one, there's a plastic tab that snaps over here, plus the rivets. So, that is how to wire a three-way switch here in the country I'm born in. We use 120 volts. Red, black, blue are your live colors. And in commercial, like for 208 and in a house, it's red and black is live, and white is neutral, but occasionally the white may be live, like in a switch loop or in a 240 volt circuit. And we use a 14 gauge wire on 15 amps. We use a 12 gauge on 20 amps. And when you put a wire around a screw, you always put it around the screw the direction that the screw turns. Peace. Thanks for watching.